I'm here today to talk about the AIR2G2, give you some quick tips on how to operate the machine and also get the best out of the machine. The AIR2G2 is a self-propelled pedestrian aerator. It works off compressed air, so unlike other aerators, it injects from the bottom up, aerating the whole profile with minimum disturbance. You can go work to a depth of 12 inches, but you actually get a little bit further because the air is coming out at the same time, so that way it'll go a little bit further down. So to get the machine ready for use, what we're going to do is lift up the little locking collars on the probes. We're going to undo the chain and also fold out the beams. To lift up the locking collars, we need an Allen key, which is stored in the toolbox. In the toolbox, you'll find all the tools that you need to maintain the machine on a regular basis. Here, we'll get the Allen key out. Okay, so I'm going to move the locking collar up out of the way. Just use a little Allen key, undo it, move it up near to the top of the ram. This will allow the probe to travel. Lock it off. Next thing we're going to do is extend the beam out, fold it out. So you just pull up the pin, extend it out, lock it back down. Last thing is the chain. Undo the little clip. It's got a little locking collar for it. We'll do the same on the other side and the machine's ready to use. Okay, so now we're ready to go. We're going to start the engine up, move it to the area that you want to work. I'm going to turn the computer on, press 1 for auto, and then press both the triggers at the same time, and then it will run through the cycle. To start the machine, we'll just turn the key. As soon as you hear that little injection go, then we can turn the key and start. If it's got a low battery or what have you, you can lift this little toggle up, and that'll take the pressure off the compressor. Always ensure the revs is about halfway when you're starting it, then you can build them up or turn them down. Okay, so to turn the computer on, lift the little red tab, switch it on. Now it'll say select mode, 1 for auto, 2 for manual. You always press 1 for auto. We need to make sure that the probe pressure is set around 4 bar to start with, and also the injection pressure is set around 20 to 25 psi. Okay, so now the computer's on, it's ready to run through its cycle. What it's going to do is it's going to push the beam down, it's going to fire 3 probes into the ground, it's going to inject twice. So if it finds a hard layer, it'll inject there, and it'll carry on going down, and then it'll inject again. Then it'll lift the probes up, and then lift the beam up. To do that, all we're going to do is press 1 trigger, and then press the other one. Okay, so when using the machine, I like to walk with it backwards to help keep a straight line, but you can use it going forwards. Always try and do the longest part of the green so we can get it done quicker. All I'm going to do is press the 2 triggers at the same time, then I'm going to take 2 steps backwards and press them again. Okay, so if we press 2 for manual, we've got 2 options, motion and timer. If we press 1 for motion, it gives us a probe and the beam. If we press 2 for beam, and then it says 1 for toggle, this will send the beam down. And then if we go backwards, we go to probe, press 1 for probe, do the same again, we can test the probes going up and down. Go back, press the beam. Check the beam's going up. If we go back again, so that's motion done. If we go to timer, press 2 for timer, we've got probe, air and beam. Probe and beam are factory set, you can't do anything in that. But for air, we can check, adjust it. So it's 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. So 2 for air. Then we've got on time or blowout. So if we do on time, this is actually when it's injecting. you'll see it's flashing. We can change that from 1 second to 1.5 second and anywhere in between. So if you think about it, that's 10% more air if we do 1.1 seconds. Press enter and that'll save it. So to adjust the injection pressure, we're just going to turn this little handle. You can see the gauge moving up to the required pressure. If we want to lock it off, just push it in and then we can't adjust it. Likewise, pull it out to adjust it. Okay, to change the tine, in the toolbox we've got a big spanner. This size for the pad, this size to lock this probe. Stick it into the little slot, then a 3/4 spanner. Okay, so when we put it back on, slide it in, turn it along, tighten up the 4 little nuts, and plug back in your pipes. Easiest way to remember is top one goes to the top, middle one to the middle, and bottom to the bottom. So middle one to the middle. Push them in. That's it, it's back on. Okay, so to take the hood off, we're going to release both these straps, undo the petrol cap, slide it back, unclip it, put the petrol cap back on. To allow us to take the cylinder off the machine and change the tine on a bench, we just turn this little valve off, it'll stop the pressure going to the bottom pipe, and we can release the quick release fittings. So the controls of the machine, basic controls, we've got the two triggers to start when it's all running, that runs through the cycle. We've got an emergency stop should it all go wrong. We've got an operator's manual inside here. Here we've got the probe pressure adjustment. This it adjusts the amount of pressure being pressed down on the probes. The injection pressure adjustment, this adjusts the amount of pressure being injected into the ground. Here we've got the on switch for the computer, we've got the computer controls, and the light that shows you when the air is actually being injected into the ground. Here we've got an hour clock to show you how many hours the machine has done. We have a little list of do's and a little list of don'ts, what to do when you're using the machine. And here we've got the fuel cap where we put the petrol. If you run out of petrol on the green, what you can do is you can remove the hood by undoing these two straps, take off the cap, lift the hood up, slide it back. Then you'll see the fuel tank is actually quick release on these two little straps here and two quick release fittings. Then you can remove the fuel tank, take it off the green, fill it up there and bring it back on. Safe spilling fuel on the green. Okay, so after every green or after about an hour's use, we'll just let the water trap go. A quick. That's enough just to let the moisture out of the tank. If the beam's locking all the way down and it's not coming up, maybe it's going over centre. To stop that, we can restrict the amount of movement by the little locking bolt under here. Just wind that out half a turn. At the end of the night, we have to drain all the air out of the system. To do that, we'll turn the computer on, press 8. Let it drain all the way out. Then when it's got a little bit of pressure left in it, we'll drain it out of the tank here. So for the portable hand probe, if you want to use in bunkers or whatever, that will go into here. Clip into here and then that runs off the system pressure. So we need to put the machine into neutral, literally just turn this over, then we can push it. But there's always a part break on when the handles are in neutral position. Okay, so with it in the neutral position, you have to move the handles to release the part break. It's best not to push the handles because it'll stretch the cable. So we move the handles and then push on the machine somewhere else and push the machine. Okay, so when you're transporting the machine on a trailer, we can lower these feet. We've got a little clip here, pull it out, lower it down, put it back in. And then when you tie the strap down, we've got tie points, one in each corner. It actually doesn't strap against the wheel, it straps against the leg to keep it safe. When demoing the machine, it's good to get a visual of how much air is actually coming out of each probe. We take this off, and we can put a balloon on it. And press the triggers.